Hello everyone. So in last lecture we have seen few in-text question from alcohol phenol ether. We'll see the remaining question, that is question number 11.9. Write the reaction or equation for Reimer-Timmen reaction and Kolbe's reaction. So what is Reimer-Timmen reaction? In Reimer-Timmen reaction, phenol changes into salicylaldehyde. So what is phenol? This is the phenol when it react with first chloroform, that is CHCl3, in presence of aqueous or alcoholic KOH, followed by reaction with water in acidic medium, gives us formation of salicylaldehyde, or which is also called as orthohydroxybenzaldehyde. Salicylaldehyde, or it is also called as orthohydroxybenzaldehyde. This reaction is called as Reimer-Timmen reaction. So next reaction is the Kolbe's reaction. In Kolbe's reaction, our starting compound is same, that is phenol. So what happens exactly when phenol reacts with carbon NaOH first? First reagent is NaOH, that is base. It produces phenoxide ion, then it reacts with carbon dioxide, then it gives carboxylic group at the ortho position of phenoxide. At the third step, reaction with water in acidic medium gives us salicylic acid. This molecule is nothing but salicylic acid. It is also called as orthohydroxybenzoic acid. Orthohydroxybenzoic acid. So these two reactions are nothing but Reimer-Timmen reaction and Kolbe's reaction. Remember, in Reimer-Timmen reaction, we get dichlorocarbene as a reaction intermediate. Dichlorocarbene is produced during the conversion of phenol into salicylaldehyde. So in NEET examination or JE examination, that MCQ will be asked to you, that which intermediate is produced when phenol gets converted into salicylaldehyde. So the next question is, write the reactions of Williamson synthesis of 2-ethoxy-3-methylpentane starting from ethanol and 3-methylpentanetol. So what is given to us starting compound as a ethanol? What is the formula of ethanol? CH3CH2OH. What is the other compound? Other compound is given to us as 3-methylpentanetol. So draw the structure of 3-methylpentanetol. Pentane means 5 carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Toluol means at second position I am having alcoholic group, at 3 position I am having methyl. Remaining are hydrogen, CH3, CH2, CH, CH, CH3. Now first question is, Williamson synthesis is used for preparation of ethers. Starting compound is alkoxide and alkyl halide. So which molecule will be considered as alkoxide? Which molecule will be considered as a alkyl halide? Remember, whenever we are having primary alkyl group, for primary alkyl group take as a alkyl halide, for secondary or tertiary alkyl group take as a alkoxide. So I will convert it into alkyl halide. Jo primary group hota hai usko hamesha alkyl halide mein convert karo, uska alkyl halide hi hona chahiye. सेकेंडरी या टर्चरी का क्या होना चाहिए? अल्कोक्साइड होना चाहिए. तो इसके लिए हम क्या करेंगे, इसको HCl या फिर HBr के साथ रिएक्ट करवाएंगे, या फिर PBr3 हमारे पास. तो इसका रोल क्या है, इट कन्वर्ट्स OH इनटू Br. सो वी गॉट हियर CH3CH2Br, दैट इज इथाइल ब्रोमाइड. इसको करना है आपको अल्कोक्साइड में कन्वर्ट, तो इसकी रिएक्शन आप सोडियम मेटल के साथ कर सकते हो. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, विल गेट हियर CH3CH2CH CH3CH CH3, this is O minus, and it will gets stabilized by Na plus, and it gives H2 as a side product, which is not our interest product. So don't look at it. So what will happen? This Na and Br together will produce NaBr as a byproduct. So what is our main product? Our main product is, now this O minus will attack on this carbon atom, bromine will leave. So the main product will be CH3, CH2, CH. CH3 is attached to it, CH, CH3. Now this oxygen will get attached to CH2, CH3. So this molecule is nothing but 3-methyl, 2-ethoxy, 3-methyl pentane is the correct structure of this molecule. So the next question is 11.12. Predict the products of following reaction. In the first reaction, we are having ether. It reacts with HBr. So this reaction is a cleavage of ether. So whenever we are giving HBr in this case, remember at the cold condition, one alkyl group will form alcohol, other will form alkyl bromide or alkyl halide. At hot condition, both will form alkyl halide. In this case, alkyl bromide at hot condition. At cold condition, one is the alkyl bromide, other is the alcohol. Remember, small alkyl group always form alkyl bromide. So I will get here CH3Br. Large alkyl group will always form a alcohol. So the product will get CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. But in this case, instead of HBr, we are using HI. No doubt, it is also hydrogen halide. So in that case, you have to remember when one of the alkyl group is tertiary. So even though it is a large group, but it won't form alcohol. It is an exception. It will form alkyl halide. That is in this case, alkyl iodide. So one of the alkyl group is a tertiary. So it will form tertiary butyl iodide. And the remaining part will form the alcohol. Remaining alkyl group will form the alcohol here. So in next example, condition is given, that is HBr. Here we are having HBr. It is aromatic ether. So whenever aromatic ethers are given, your one product is fixed. You will get phenol definitely. It means this hydrogen gets attached to the benzene attached to oxygen. So remaining C2H5 will definitely form bromide, that is C2H5Br. Some conditions are there for the cleavage of ether that you have to remember. For example, if we are having aromatic ether, in that case, phenol is the first product we will get. Rest alkyl group will form alkyl added. Whenever we are having tertiary alkyl group in ether, that tertiary alkyl group will always form a halide, that is alkyl added in this case. Whenever we are having one small alkyl group, one large alkyl group, then that small alkyl group will form bromide, that is iodide, and large alkyl group will form alcohol. Now this reaction is a nitration, because HNO3 plus HTSO4 is a nitrating mixture, and this is the aromatic ether. We know that aromatic ether undergo nitration. This OC2H5 is the orthoparadirecting group. Nitration means what? Replacement of hydrogen by nitro group. So we got nitro at the ortho position, that is 2 position, and in another case we will get nitro at the para position. No doubt para product is always the major product of the reaction. Because of the 1-4 relation, steric hindrance is very less, while ortho product 1-2 relation causes a lot of steric hindrance, unstable molecule, and hence that product formation will be the minor. So thank you so much. Have a nice time. Take care.